Okay. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to this class, yeah, English for Communication. I really appreciate, I really appreciate your presence in this early morning, yeah. And then we will try to force ourselves using English, yeah. Whether maybe sometimes we will mix it with bahasa, it's okay, but first let's merge ourselves into an English context, ya. Kita mulai, ya. Kita usahakan nanti dengan berbahasa Inggris, we will create the English environment, ya, especially this class. This meeting is also being recorded. That's why those who come late later on can see the recording, yeah, in the given link in the e-learning. Yeah. Okay, let's start. This first meeting will have a discussion related with our course, yeah, the course grid, or we can call it the syllabus, briefly. Then after that, we are going to discuss about communication in general, yeah, just for introduction, because this is still first meeting, and I hope you will not get bored with this class, yeah, in the first meeting, and then we will have a full hours to discuss about the material. Okay, let's start with this situation, yeah. I have explained before that we need to force ourselves, yeah, to merge with English environment. If we do not have a chance outside of this class, so we will maximize this class to develop our English skills. Yeah, even started with the receptive skill, listening to me, listening to the explanation is one of the, what is that, way to learn. Then especially later on, you can create your productive skill through the speaking or through the writing, yeah, related with the course, of course. Yeah, so this is me. I will introduce myself first. My name is Agustinus Hari Setiawan, yeah. You can call me Hari. Usually in Ilkom, they call it Mas, yeah. Just call it Mas Hari or Mr. Hari, it's okay, yeah. I'm majoring in linguistics, yeah. It's one of the field in English education study program. So if we know about language, yeah, linguistics is the study about language. Okay. Then we are going to discuss. Yeah, this one about communication. In the early meeting, yeah, we'll have a brief introduction. But if we talk about the common definition, yeah, related with what's that? There is a source or a speaker, and then there is a encoding, then there is media or something like that. Yeah, it is transmitted to the air and extra. Then there will be decoding. Then there will be a listener, or we can call it interlocutors, or people who are in charge in the conversation. Yeah, that's too common. Now we will discuss about the unique definition, yeah. I take it from Fiske, yeah, later on, yeah. this course is about the discussion of media, yeah. That's why our scoring criteria will be related with this. Saya admit yang pelan-pelan. Then, why we talk about the scoring criteria in the beginning, yeah, before the definition. Later on, we will discuss about that unique definition from FISCE. But I will give you a preliminary related with our course. It is different with what's that? The previous semester, yeah, and the previous year. We are using MBKM, yeah, the 2021 curriculum. That's why it's different with the 2017 curriculum. It based on the outcome. Namanya itu OBE, ya. Yeah. Outcome based education. Sebentar, jam. Okay, we will continue, yeah. What is OBE, Outcome Based Education? Will, yeah, it is related with MBKM, Merdeka Belajar Kampus Merdeka, ya. Yeah, will relate us with the field. Yeah, the education field with the working field. That's why it based on the outcome. We need to create something, a product. Product doesn't just mean about a product that can be seen, yeah. It can be a skill, it can be a video, and extra. Yeah, we'll continue. Related with this, that's why we have a different assessment. If in the previous one we have in SIA we have attendance, we have classroom participation or activeness. Yeah, we have a different one right now, yeah. We have assessment 1, assessment 2, assessment 3, assessment 4, and assessment 5. It's differ in every course. Yeah, maybe in your other lecturer will be different because it depends on the characteristic of each course. Yeah. Yeah, it's unique, yeah. Okay. It depends on the characteristic of the course. That's why in English for Communication, di kelas saya, di kelas kita, itu ada 5 ASN. There are 5 ASN. Yeah. It will be assessed during each subtopics. Yeah. If we have several subtopics and it's related with one thing, we will assess that. So your score later on will be dependent, yeah, on this. SN1, SN2, SN3, SN4, SN5. So the UTS will be in the middle of it. Jadi mungkin nanti SN3 ya, SN3 or SN2 will be converted into UTS, then SN5 will be converted into final examination or UAS. And then how about the attendance? The attendance will merge into this. Tentu saja ya, you need to have the minimum requirement to attend this class, to attend our class, ya. Yeah? Like usual, based on the rector degree, 75% ya, with the academic the rule, ya. Yeah? 75% on, yeah, we'll divide it 16 meeting by 75%. Or in other words, you are allowed to be absent, ya, yeah? 25%. So, you can be absent, yeah, 3 times. Yeah, if more than that, please communicate with me because we have a humanism point of view, humanism approach, yeah. So we are not robot, that's why please communicate with the lecturer about that situation, yeah, because we don't know about something happens in the future, yeah. Okay, then next after scoring criteria, we have the grading, yeah. We have the grading with that, this one. Yeah, this is the new grading. It's very easy, yeah. You can see on the SIA or in other, what is that? In other sources, yeah, from our academic rule. There is no A per B dan sebagainya ya, yang dulu mungkin teman-teman pernah mengetahuinya ya. This is the new one from 2019. Okay, then we have a discussion related with our material in this semester. First, we have today's meeting ya, synchronous. Then we will mix it ya. Sometimes we will do synchronous meeting like this. Sometimes we will do asynchronous meeting, just following what's that, the PPT or the presentation or the other one task, yeah, on the e-learning. And then sometimes we have a online meeting like this. Yeah, we will mix. Okay, then the second week, next week, we'll discuss about newspaper. Yeah. It's quite old this or old school, but this is important. This is for our jumping stone to another level, because we in discussing about an article in a general related with the popular media, for example, we need to know about cohesion of the text, word choice, and etc. That's why newspaper, yeah, need to be mastered first. Then radio, yeah, we can see that nowadays radio is same with newspaper, yeah, quite oldies. That's why those are changing, become e-newspaper, become radio that can be accessed through the internet, yeah, or we can call it the podcast and extra, yeah. But why this is still important for our basic, yeah. Then the next we have magazine for our topic discussion, yeah. Once again, before we continue, yeah. In English for Communication, the purpose is studying about communication field on the surface, not in the deep thing, because there is not enough for 3 credits in discussing all topics in English. Yeah, we will choose some, then it will represent about the English for Communication materials. Then after that, we will have a television. Yeah, about the language of television. Then about the linguistic aspect about this, like modality, yeah, then the vocabulary use and extra, yeah. You can read this and then you can reread in the recording video later on. Then the other one, we have film, that is the feature of written dialogue, then started from once again receptive, so we can read, yeah, the script, the movie script writing, know what is the definition of this, for example, the scene, the heading, yeah, the TXT, what does it mean, an extra, yeah. Then comes to the productive skill, but just, yeah, in a glance, yeah, maybe you will perform what you have read from the script writing, the movie script writing, you then perform it in the simple way, yeah, not in the complicated way, because we have a short script, for example, right? That's about film. Then after that, we'll have a new media. That is a technical vocabulary, yeah, in the several websites, yeah, like our current modern technology right now, yeah. Okay, then we come to mid exam. But remember, during the course orientation till mid exam, we have ASN, yeah. The assessment maybe newspaper, radio, and magazine become one related with the basic thing. Then the television, movie, or film, and new media will be another ASN, and it will be converted into UTS and extra. Yeah. Then after the first period, we have the second one after the mid exam, we will discuss about the advertising. Yeah, about the language of slogan. We have a vocabulary related with advert and extra. Then after that, we'll have a marketing. Yeah, for marketing communication. Yeah, then describing about market trends, the vocabulary use of communication strategy and extra. Then we'll spend a meeting to have a practice. Yeah, whether we will brainstorm and revoke the previous meeting related with radio, what's that, television and stuff, or especially about advertising and marketing. Yeah, then the rest of it will be about scientific writing in 12, 13, 14. Yeah, we have a journal discussion. We will start it from Indonesian journal first related with communication field. Once again, yeah, related with yours, related with your field, because you have mastered it in several semester, right? Then we need to discuss it in English. Then the second and third chance in discussing the journal will change. We will have another level, yeah, with discussing English journal related with communication science. Then because this is OBA, we will have kind of a final product of our project, yeah. That's why in the last meeting I will allocate it to have a project preparation, so you can have your preparation and see the guidance and extra. And then when we, you have English silent, a week of silent, yeah, or minggu tenang seperti itu, nanti teman-teman bisa tambah ada waktu for the final project. Yep. Then after discussing about our course grade, what we are going to do is about the communication itself, ya, yeah, in the beginning, in the tadi yang saya singgung di awal tentang FISK, ya, yeah. We have many definition once again from the interlocutors, receptive, ya, yeah. We have several famous of communication definition. Now we have the unique for our warming up. Ini pemanasan di pertemuan pertama, ya. This unique definition from FISK, ya, in 1993. I took it from the old references. Let's read it together. Then I will maybe ask you to make kind of your opinion related with this definition. You may to read it in your mind, ya. Once again. Communication is one of those activities that everyone recognizes, but few can define satisfactorily. Communication is talking to one another, it's television, it's spreading information, it's our hairstyle, it's literary criticism, then the list is endless. Yeah. Sekarang untuk partisipasi kelas, ya, untuk pemanasan for our warming up, siapa? Dari teman-teman, ya, who want to give your opinion related with this definition, what does it mean, ya, yeah. Maybe first it can be in bahasa, or if you wanna try you can mix it in English or use English, ya, yeah. I will open the discussion. Who want to share the opinion related with this? Ada yang mau nyoba? This is not the common definition, yeah. That's why we will discuss about it. Communication is one of those activities that everyone recognizes, but few can define satisfactorily. Apa ini? Dari satu kalimat dulu. Is there anyone who want to say? You can open a mic and say your opinion about this. Maybe I will ask randomly, ya, one or two students for classroom participation. Yeah, it's okay. I will not ask all of you, yeah, but just one or two students. Maybe it comes to Mbak tadi yang datang rumah saudara di nanti. What is your opinion related with the first sentence, Mbak Dara? Can you hear my voice? Halo, Mbak Dara, Dinanti. No response? Yeah? Okay. Then maybe I will ask Mbak Nailan Salsabila. Can you hear my, yeah, Mbak Nailan? Thank you for responding me. What is your opinion related with this definition? Maybe start it from the first sentence.
I think si pemahaman saya tentang definisi ini mungkin komunikasi itu sudah bagian dari aktivitas sehari-hari bagi manusia, komunikasi itu. Semua juga menggunakan komunikasi ini, tetapi beberapa sebagian orang dapat hanya dapat mendefinisikan hanya dapat mendefinisikan untuk memuaskan apa ya sedikit yang bisa mendefinisikan gitu dari komunikasi ini.
Okay.
Jadi komunikasi ini is talking to one another, first one person to another person, individually or individu, jadi cara fisik dari media, kemudian spreading information dari menjelaskan.
Yeah, maybe the voice is lost. Okay, but the opinion from Mbak Nailan is okay. Yeah, that's correct. Thank you. Yeah. Maybe the internet connection. That's okay, Mbak Nailan. Yeah. That's okay. That communication, yeah, in a general definition, like source, there is a utterances, then decoding, encoding, extra. Yeah. That's correct, Mbak Nailan. That it is one to another. Yeah. This is for internet connection. That's okay. But few can define it satisfactorily, yeah. Sehari-hari tadi everyone recognize, yeah, it happens in our daily situation, that's correct. Then few, communication has a purpose to transfer information, yeah, to transfer something through that communication media. But, yeah, few can get done successfully, yeah, itu maksudnya, yeah. Sometimes it's success, sometimes it's not. There is miscommunication, there is a barrier. Yeah, thank you about the first sentence and yeah, briefly about the second sentence. Now, the next, yeah, random yang kedua after Mbak Naila. There is the definition, yeah. Communication is talking to one another, it's television, it's spreading information. Ini unik menurut saya. It's our hairstyle. It's literally criticism. The list is endless. We will take one point. Satu saja mungkin ya sebagai contoh. It is our hairstyle. Nah, ini kan Fiske itu karena it is the list is endless, banyak sekali ya. Ya. Kenapa Fiske? Why Fiske highlight the it is our hairstyle? Why it is communication? Maybe I will ask ya randomly after the female, maybe we'll try to hear another beautiful voice from the male, ya. Mas Dava, maybe. Mas Dava Dawami. Can you hear me? Mas Dava? Hello, Mas Dava? If not, maybe I will change. Can you hear me, Mas Dava? Not yet. Okay, Mas Agung Dimas. Can you respond to me, Mas Agung? Mas Agung? No need to turn on the video, yeah. Just maybe you can turn on the mic. It's okay. Mas Agung? No? Yeah, respond. Okay, now Mbak Desa Nirmala. Mbak Desa. Halo Mbak Desa. Mbak ya. Okay, Mbak Laurencia Ayu. Can you respond to me?
Or maybe let me answer it.
Okay. Can I know the name? Maybe I will take a note. I do not see the name yet. Ini siapa tadi? Can I know it?
Is it me?
Yeah, yeah. Mbak Ninda or
Aulia?
Aulia. Okay. Mbak Aulia. So please, the time is yours.
Ya ini yang tentang hairstyle itu bukan?
Yep. Maybe you can highlight on hairstyle.
Just like what it said, communication is talking to one another. It is television. It's spreading information. It's our hairstyle. It's literally criticism. It might be because we see each other, we talk to each other. That's hairstyle. It depend on what people see on us, mm-hmm. or like the fashion, the outfit, everything, or maybe the face. But yeah, it's everything. It might be our food, also it's the song or
yeah,
everything that we can communicate. It's yeah. Like that.
Okay, can you explain more about it depends on the person that see us? Yeah, can you explain about that more? It is about what?
Because sometimes we see a person to start a communication, to start talking to people. We see like, wow, I like your hair. Wow, I like your hairstyle, or wow, I like your fashion. How you do that? It's just that's my opinion.
Okay, yeah, great. Thank you, Aulia. Yeah, we have several points related with your opinion. Yeah, that's correct. Because after knowing about the process and extra about the field or the scope, yeah, in our daily one about the percentage of being successfully or not, yeah, it talks about another field about communication samples. Yeah, Fiske give this one, then we discuss about hairstyle, and it's explained very well by Mbak Aulia. Yeah, it depends on others. Yeah, that's also the point, because we have a hairstyle. Maybe we have long hair, we have a short hair, we have bald, we have dread, we have a rasta, something like that style. Yeah, and then another one, we talk about song and extra food. Yeah, it's also related. It depends on other perspective. Yeah, this is a communication because we show verbal and nonverbal communication, right? This is about, for example, nonverbal. Nonverbal say many things, and the other one receive many things. It depends on, yeah, the other perception. And then, for example, about the dread. Oh, he is a slow one. It means a very relaxed guy, because maybe the song is he likes to this one, his characteristic is this one. Yeah, this is kind of communication, but still about maybe a guessing prediction from others. But about the heartfelt, it shows something. That's also nonverbal communication. Yeah, that's the point. Thank you, Mbak Aulia. Yeah, so something maybe about physical appearance, something that we see, and etc. Yeah, okay, then we can relate it with another like song, food. Okay, that's why it is communication. Yeah, the definition of it. We'll continue. Nah, itu tadi. Yeah, this is the point. We will skip this. We have discussed about it. Yeah. More about perception, yeah, we will see about this. maybe I will give you another chance to make an opinion related with this. Want to give opinion? What kind of picture is it? What do you think? Yeah. Maybe I will ask Mbak Nanda, Amalia. Can you hear me, Mbak Nanda?
Hello, sir.
Yeah. What do you think about this? What is it?
I think that is like a flag or seperti kain yang menyangkut di ranting pohon.
Okay. Do you know the location? Do you know the situation? What is the purpose? Do you know about it?
No.
Not yet. Okay. Thank you, ya, Mbak Nanda. Now we'll change to another picture with the same color, with the same fabrics, yeah, materials, but with a different point of view. So I will ask another one, Mbak Deva Mauliana.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So like the Mbak the previous question about Mbak Mananda answer, yeah, but it's different picture. What do you think about it?
In my opinion, the red flags is for warning or reminder or cautions for not do something in that place.
Okay, that place. Can you say what place is it?
It's a beach. Pantai, sir.
Yeah, beach. Okay, that's good. Then the purpose, not to?
Not to, if I see in this picture, it's not to swimming.
Yeah, not to swim. Thank you, yeah. That's an enough information to explain it in details, yeah. There is a beach, there is a prohibition, not to swim over there, yeah. Across the border that already been made by the security guard and extra, yeah. With that information. So, yeah, briefly, we can conclude temporarily, yeah, from those two pictures that the first picture we cannot say in detail. We cannot make sure about it. Yeah, yeah, but what Nanda said is correct. But we cannot make sure that this is the where is the location? Is it on the peak of a mountain? Is it on the beach? Is it near our house? Yeah, what is the purpose? We cannot say because of limited context. Yeah, that's why in our first meeting, we'll try to make sure that we as a language learner know about this thing. Yeah, if we want to say about something, meaning we need to know about the context. If the context is general, yeah, it can have many interpretation and it's not sure yet. If the context is details like this, yeah, we can make sure about the information. Yeah, we can say about the context is time, place, nuance, yeah, and extra. Then about this, in the other picture, whether we have the same thing with details context, but we can have a different one. Yeah. Ini tentang apa? Kalau yang ini? Yang tahu? Do you know about this? This is about funeral. Yeah. Yeah, burial ceremony, in other words. Yeah, in some place it's using white flag, but this is about yellow flag. And then in some places, they use a different one, yeah, or without using anything. Yeah, that's mixed. But here we have a different color, same fabric, but in different place, say different things. Yeah, the point is, yeah, because this is sacred, holy place. The previous one is about funeral activity. Yeah, funeral ceremony. Yeah, the second conclusion about what we are going to discuss related to those four pictures whether the same details, it consists of details one, context, but in the different places, different situation, different time, it can inform different thing related with one fabric, one color, yeah? It's so different. That's why it's related with the context. It depends. That's why in our discussion, we will say that context is important. Our understanding related with thing is important. So it comes to the understanding related with object with five senses. Object here can be seen, or it is about adjective and extra, yeah, it can be seen. Five senses, yeah, it can be visual, it can be about hearing, smelling, and extra, yeah. So that's the point. Someone can know something because of their experience once again. So as a language learner in the first meeting, as a basic thing, yeah, so we can know that everyone have a different background experience. So later on, if we implement our skills outside there, we can maintain a good situation. Yeah, in a simple way, for example, when you do social services, KKN, and you meet kind of people outside there that do not have the same background knowledge with you, you will low down your word choice. You can explain it with the more humble way, yeah? Not like this, misalnya dengan buruh gendong or the pedicab driver. Sir, we will have a training, then we will have a syllabus related with this meeting. It is about this approach. Approach, syllabus, makanan apa itu? They don't know it. But if they have, you have implemented with a good way, because they have a different background experience with you, yeah? Mereka mungkin belum pernah mendengar kata silabus, pernah melihat tentang sesuatu ini. Jadi kita harus menggunakan, we will use another level that same with them. Ya, ini tentang our understanding related with
related.
Okay.
Lumayan.
Oke, ini definisi umum, kita akan skip karena tadi kita sudah we will discuss about others. This is the common definition ya, of communication. We will skip. Nah, this is the other point tadi. Sesuai yang bisa dibilang Mbak Aulia, then the other one ya. Yeah. If you see this picture, maybe yeah, you have your device on the landscape view, you can say that this is chick and bird. But if you have a portrait view, you can say that this is rabbit and cat. For example, this is a child drawing, yeah, not a good one. Yeah, rabbit and cat. So we got the point that our response related with this picture depends on what we see in what way. It's called by our process of getting information. Yeah, after knowing about the context and extra, we also a position, maintenance about our that situation, we can also have this process of getting information. So our point of view is called by perception. So if we see something, if we see a word, if we see a picture, if we see situation, it depends on our point of view. This is called by perception. And then we as a human identify this or use a thinking or in the next level, critical thinking. Then we have our productive, that is the interpretation of what we have said, we have seen, we have heard, and extra. Yeah, this is the process of getting information, perception, identification, then interpretation. So we know each other during communication, their perception will be different, yeah, because of their point of view. That's why it will create different interpretation. Okay, that's the closing, because this is the first meeting. If I explain more and more, it will be kind of boring. Yeah, you will get bored. That's why you can see this, and then you can whether explore, then wait for the next meeting, yeah, for our discussion related about newspaper. But I will have the last discussion, yeah. This is not about material, that this is just a trivia question for our closing. Please answer this, yeah, quickly. You can raise your hand or open your mic, yeah. Raise your hand through this one or open directly open the mic, yeah. Then say your name, yeah. This warming up question, yeah. Can you tell me, yeah? You can answer this one with reading first using your receptive skill. Can you tell me what occur twice in a week, once in a year, but never in a day? Can anyone answer this question? This is not the very, academic questions, but it shows your critical thinking.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, Mbak Leoni.
I've been here this jokes.
Yeah.
There's a word, E. Letter E.
Can you explain?
On the word week.
Week. How many E in week?
Two. Twice.
Then? Then? About year?
Letter one, E on the year. Just okay. One E on that.
Okay, then about day?
No letter E on that.
Yeah, good, yeah. It's with the requirement that twice in a week, once in a year, but never in a day. Thank you, yeah, Mbak Leoni. It shows whether this is not quite academic, but it relate, it's kind of analogy related with the what Kaedler said. Process of getting information, yeah, perception, identification, then interpretation. If another one, maybe except of Mbak Leoni, we'll say it as activity, yeah, maybe using a translate. What occur, apa yang muncul dua kali dalam seminggu, satu kali dalam setahun, tetapi tidak pernah dalam sehari, apa ya? Ya, if you think about activity, no one can match this requirement, ya. Oh, ulang tahun, ya, sekali setahun, tapi twice in a week, no. And blah, 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 ya. But in different windows, ya, or point of view, ya, we have this perception that is matched with this. What occur twice in a week, we do not translate, but we understand it. Twice in, not a week, is not just literal a week, but word week, ya. Yeah? This one. W-E-E-K. Oh, twice E. Is that okay with the next one? Year. Oh, one in a year. Year E. Yeah, extra. So that's the requirement of this one. That's okay, yeah. That's our closing for this, yeah. Now I will over if you have a question related with this, yeah. You may ask your question sambil saya presensi ya. Kalau ada pertanyaan, saya tak catat dulu kehadiran. Ya, yeah. Whether it is recorded, but I need to make it simpler, right? Ya, yeah. By having is there any questions? Yeah, it's okay, yeah. I read the chat, yeah, Mbak Leoni, yeah. Because something is based on our experience, yeah. The other student maybe do not know it yet. Yeah, itu tadi, based on our background experience related with this joke or in simple way in related to vocabulary, yeah, meaning and extra. Yeah, that's the point. If there is no question, we will close this meeting, ya. Yeah. Bentar, ada yang baru masuk. Nggak apa-apa, saya hargai, ya. Oke. Okay. Masuk untuk saya greeting ini, ya. Closing, ya. Oke, okay, Mbak Helen, Mbak Ninda, welcome. Mbak, so sorry, you can listen on watch on the recording, ya, yeah, because the first meeting is going to be end, Yeah, it will be ended soon. Thank you. For this meeting, we'll briefly discuss about what we are going to do during the semester and then about the point of basic communication. Yeah, not all of things that we can discuss in the first meeting. Yeah, we, next week we'll have another discussion. Yeah. Thank you very much. I got the attendance for today's meeting. Nanti teman-teman lainnya, mungkin besok saya akan upload di YouTube dan linknya akan saya masukkan kalau teman-teman yang lain di luar meeting akan melihatnya. Oke, okay. I will end this meeting. Thank you very much ya, yeah, everyone. Stay healthy, sehat selalu untuk teman-teman semua. Saya hargai untuk bahasa Inggris itu adalah effort dulu ya, usaha teman-teman. About the English skill, it will be the second and third. Ya, kalau ada pertanyaan, lanjut nanti bisa ditanyakan di WhatsApp group juga ya. Thank you very much. See you. Goodbye.
See you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.